Good morning, YouTube fam, and welcome to another episode of Fishing That. Yes, it is your boy Rosie, your soon-to-be number one YouTube host. All right, family, we are at Sam Houston Jones State Park. Love it here in one of my top five spots. The only reason is probably not number three or four. I take that back. It might be in my top eight spots. The truck is about 120 yards from my fishing spot. Now, y'all know I love fishing boat launches. One of my favorite things to do. Fish tend to hang out here. Boat fishermen don't stop and fish right here, because why would they have a boat if they're going to fish right here at the boat launch? So they leave all that fish for us bank fishermen. All right, family, I'm getting blown out right there. Okay, that's better. All right, fam, so we haven't been here to Sam Houston for a while, so we decided to give her a try. There's a down tree right there. Been there ever since the hurricane for years. Got to be careful right there in that spot, but right there every now and then is prime fishing. Somebody, which I think there are cabins here. This is a state park. There's camping here, cabins here, hundreds of acres here. There's deer out here, the whole nine yards, you name it. The river, Calcasieu River systems run right through here. That's what we're fishing. So I think somebody might be in a cabin up here and they left their boat, but I see their coffee cups, the whole nine yards. So hopefully they come back and move their boat and give me free access to this whole area. Cause I would like to tight line, even though there's gonna be debris out here, I like to tight line straight out. All right, family, so y'all are all caught up. Y'all know what we're doing, you know where we're at. So let's go ahead and get started and see if we put a couple in the boat. Stay tuned. All right, fam, what we'll be fishing with, and we're gonna get this guy, we're gonna be out here about an hour. And if this doesn't work, we're gonna head up on the other side of the river, about 400 or 500 yards up that way. And supposedly there's some fish biting up that way, rumor has it. So we're gonna be using our Sea Knight 2000 series rapid reel and see exactly, this is the third time we've used it, and so far, this thing has been amazing. Still as smooth as it was the first day I got it, the first time I cast it. All right, family, so without further ado, let's go ahead and get in the water behind this rag. I've already sprayed my perimeter. One of the things, and this is an amateur tip, always spray your perimeter. I get tired of those ants and stuff, so I remembered this morning to grab my rig, and I just did a little square around where I'll be sitting and where I'll be fishing, where I'll be operating. All right, fam, that's an amateur tip. Put my rag down, get out some of my stuff. I even got a bag of shrimp. This is a video y'all haven't seen yet, fam. Y'all will probably see it here in the next week. Lady Red and I went to Cameron. We went camping, and we camped right next to where all the tugboats and stuff come in and bring in goods and move equipment around in this region, and we had an awesome weekend. Y'all stay tuned for that one. And we got a bag of shrimp. This is not all of them, this is about half. We get there $3 to $4 a pound. Bam, can't beat it. So I'm gonna let these thaw out and I'll be using those on my tight line whenever this gentleman comes back and grabs this boat. Ooh, I got a couple of shrimp in here, y'all. Make sure I got worms. I think those worms made it. Nope, they're coming apart. I think those worms got too cold. Yeah, they're frozen. They got too cold in the RV, y'all. Ooh, I hope I got another box in there. If not, we're gonna be fishing with shrimp all freaking morning. Did I put another box in here? Nope. Oh, yes, I did. Yes, I did. Let's see what we got. Make sure they aren't frozen. Nothing. Empty box. Freaking fracker. God dang it. All right, fam. Can't go back home. We got fish to clean from our camping trip. We're gonna do that today. But fam, it looks like we're gonna be fishing with shrimp all day. God dang it. Man, I hate making rookie mistakes. All right, fam. Well, and those shrimps aren't in the best condition either, y'all. Dang it. I may have to call my daughter and tell her to bring me a box of worms. I don't think I have artificial bait in there. Nah, that's not gonna stay at all. Got your Mickey. What a mess. Y'all know I keep it real. We're gonna salvage this day, even if we gotta leave and go get a box of worms. But I mainly wanna see if there's fish in here. If I can get those other shrimp to thaw out rather quickly, we'll be in business. They're still on there, not even on there anymore. All right. Let's see if maybe we can salvage a little bit of those worms. Bam. Man. Rookie mistake. A little bit of shrimp. Let's see if we can get that to stay on. One good thing about bank fishing, I can always leave. If I was out on the boat and this happened, oh my goodness. Total disaster, y'all. Nope, it's not gonna stay. Just a hot mess. I'm gonna wind up dumping that whole thing out because I know me, I'll keep trying to use it. His freaking boat is just drifting in my way. Still on there. Just drop down right here and just see what happens. Right here in front of us. Oftentimes, like I tell y'all, we're all concerned with the long cast, and sometimes your biggest fish is right here in front of you. Alright fam, the boat just left. They explained to me that they've come from their house somewhere a couple of miles down the road, and they walk the park in the morning. So they just leave their boat tied up here. So now that we don't have a boat in our way, we still don't have any worms, but we do have shrimp. So if something's torn, I got a feeling it's a turtle, but something's torn with my piece of shrimp. Come on, put a ring. Ah! All right, fam, we're gonna call this video something like, what do you do when you come totally unprepared? Cause that's exactly what your boy did today. Like I said, I got a lot of shrimp. Did I throw that shrimp off? Nope, still on there. I got a lot of shrimp, we just gotta let them thaw out. And this is gonna be a totally shrimp day. So we're gonna be fishing without worms all day today. Bam. Somebody went in and ate that shrimp out of his shell. Now, let's try one peel. That was one of the dilemmas I had in an upcoming video that y'all will see here in a week or so. Should I peel the shrimp or should I leave it unpeeled? I still got a few ants trying to get to me. Let me widen my horizon. All right. All right, fam. Chum it up a little bit. Gonna go ahead and get rid of the shell. I'm waiting to see that tight line tighten up, baby. Come on. All right, fam. Now that's already peeled. We're gonna start out by just dropping it right here in front of us. See what happens. Take it. Keep it. Got him, fam. Come on. I got the net. Come on, fam.
Fam.
Ho, 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 ho. Fam. Talk to your boy. Let me get him away from that water. He just broke. Oh, just broke my line. Oh, yeah. All right. Grab a rag. Fam. Oh, calm down, son. You going in the basket. Let me get some of this crap out of here. Come on. Calm down, son. I know y'all can hear me. Y'all can't see me. Check him out, fam. Booyah. Yes, sir. In the basket you go. Fam, let me get a picture of this dude on my other phone. I don't want to get too close to the water and lose this dude. Yes, sir. That is a big dude. Ho, ho, ho. Yes, indeed. Fam. Now I'm going to take this tight line and move it. I don't know if y'all can see it in the camera or not, but it's swinging right overhead. Bam. Everybody's trying to cast. Right here, just like I told y'all. No cast required. Calm down, son. Two and a half. Let's go 3 feet, y'all. Oh, by the way, for y'all who want to know exactly how to measure, this is a 6.5 foot rod. So right here, I'm about 6 feet deep. Boom. If I go all the way to the end of the handle, of course, I'm 6.5 feet. All right, fam, let's see what's lurking at 6 feet. Bam, this might not be a long video. I just want to catch a couple of fish. Then I got to clean a flounder. And now four catfish that we caught on the camping trip. Oh, all right. Already robbed. I ain't mad at you. We got plenty of shrimp where that came from. I got stuff everywhere, y'all. I got my eggs out. I got my lunch laying over here. It's all right. Let's get some more of those shrimp out to thaw out. I got them laying out as I can pick them out of the bag. And they're starting to thaw out. Kind of just laying them out in the sun and let them thaw out. Now check this out, fam. $3 a pound at one store if you pay cash. $4 at another store if you don't. These are fresh, just came. Is that one of those Catawba worm things? Hold on, hold everything, fam. Check this out. I see people fish with those things. I think they come off of like these trees or whatever. They fall out of these trees. Let's try one of those just for the hell of it. Fam, check that out. Let's try that. I'm gonna put it on the end of the hook. Because you know we'll try anything. That's how you salvage. See what y'all are seeing. Are y'all looking? Yep. Boom. All right. Where's my hook? Right here. I'm not sure what they call these, a Catawba worm or something. Y'all tell me in the comments below. Y'all fishing experts that know about all this stuff. It's not a good thread on, but let's see if something will pick that up. Ho, 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 come on. Come on, put a ring on it. And those things come right out of these trees that are right above us, man. Bam. Bam. Holy crap. Oh, now I'm looking on the ground for worms all freaking morning long, fam. Y'all saw it with your own eyes real time. He jumped on that thing like it was a steak. Oh, fam, I might. Nah, not enough. Fam. Now I can use him for cut bait on my tight line. But I think we're going to stick with the shrimp. We got a little cut bait anyway. Bam. Holy crap. So those things are up in these trees. If I see another one fall on the ground, fam, I am on it. Go live your best life, son. Woo-hoo-hoo! I seen that on other people's YouTube channels where they use them. I think they call them Catawba worms or something. And they're usually a little bit bigger than that. And that fish jumped right on that thing. All right, calm down, Rose. Calm down. What a way to salvage a day. Because I had screwed this all up. I made every amateur mistake known to mankind. All right, fam. Let's get this shrimp down there. But I don't think it's going to have the same effect that freaking worm had. Good googly moogly, fam. On our last, on that camping trip, we had a guy, a family, they brought in a huge drum, probably a 20 pounder, and that thing was full of worms when they cut it. I mean, just full with worms. So those big fish aren't always the way to go. Come on. All right. Let's get you out here a ways. That'll work. It wasn't pretty. That'll work. Let's see what y'all see. I didn't open that bell. Y'all might see my rod going in the water. Put a ring on it. He hung me up. God dang it. All right, swim me out. Swim me out. Damn it. Did we get this? At least get the barber? Yep. We at least salvaged the barber, y'all. All right. Let's go ahead and tie back on, and then we'll bring that other setup back in. Now, do we want to go? Hello.
How's it going?
Caught a huge catfish.
Did you get it on tape?
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Yep.
You having a good time?
Having a great time.
Okay. Well, I'm ready to go to bed.
Lay it down, my love. I will see you when you wake up. What the heck? Fam, do I need the net? Sitting there with it in his mouth. Let him run. Let him run. Let him run. A garfish. I think that's a gar, y'all. I think that's a gar. Yep. Bam. Check that out. Now, what do we do about that? Woo! I don't even know how I'm gonna get him off the net, out the net. Bam. Check him out. Wow. That's how you tear up a net right there. One of these freaking things. Nah. All right, fam. The work has just begun. Let's see if we get him out of the net. I've seen people grab him, but look at that freaking snout, y'all. I ain't about to grab that dude. Those teeth in there are lethal. Ah. I probably shouldn't even have netted this dude. Ah. All right, fam. His mouth is trapped. Inside the net. Let's go ahead and cut the line. First things first. We ain't worried about that. All right, now. Then we can get him out by the tail end. This is going to be violent. I wish I knew how to, whoa. All right, work yourself out. Work it out, work it out. Work it out. Woo! He swam away safely, fam. Now go away. Woo! Fam, that was exhilarating. Whole alligator gar, y'all. Normally they break the line and move on. Woo! What a rush. What a rush, man. Wow. Ah, that was exhilarating. Okay, hold on. Okay, what's next? All right, put the net down. Get your gear. Tie on. You probably stretched the crap out of this line. Bam. Oh, hold on. Hold everything. Bam. That was about, ooh, what? 4-pound gar? Shout out to my new reel. C-Knight. Come on, C-Knight. What's up, dog? The C-Knight 2000 just brought in a gar, an alligator gar. Yeah, if you're not from here, you don't know about alligator gar, look it up, fam. This reel just brought that dude in with no freaking problem. On some 8-pound test. Ho, ho, ho. We're partners. I'm not obligated to say anything good about C-Knight, but why can I not say anything good about C-Knight? Boom, check it out, fam. Didn't damage it, didn't slow it down, still smooth as butter. Yeah, baby. Whoo, calm down, Rosie, calm down. Come on, C-Knight. 2000 Rapid, come on. What is it, 6-to-2 gear ratio? For fast reeling? We didn't need no fast reeling right there though. We needed that power, baby. And it got it, it brought it. Come on. Let's get back in the water. Googly moogly. Fam, I ain't saying that weight made all the difference. Y'all see what's happening. Can y'all see that? I'm a little bit. I don't know what it is about the rate of fall. the fall rate, but it seems to make a difference. I wasn't getting those many ticks before I put that weight on. See, fam, that's all part of the hunt. That is about 7-8 feet out from the dock. Nothing. No nibble, no nothing. We know that about 7-8 feet is a good depth. Oh, hold on. Maybe I spoke too soon. Something's tapping at me. I was saying everything's in close, but maybe not. Come on, put a ring on it. Stay with it. Holy crap, y'all. Am I gonna need the net again? Where's the net? I was right here beside me. What is that, another garfish? Come on. Let him run. I wanna at least see what it is. I don't think that's a gar, y'all. Ease him in. Come on. Man, I don't think that's a gar. What is it? Come on. Oh, whatever it is, it's strong. Come on. Come on. What is it? I at least want to see it. Oh my God, it's a big old sheep head or a drum. It's a prison fish, I call it. You got stripes. Come on, I got to get the net ready. All right, I got the net right between my legs. Come on. I'm just going to tire him out. Come on. You getting tired? No, you're not. Come on. Ease that in the water. Ease the net in the water. Come on, Roselle. Don't do nothing stupid. Got him. Woo! Bam. Yes, sir. Good day. It's been an excellent day. Excellent day. Bam. And this dude is legal, I do believe. Oh, I gotta check the rules and regulations. All right. I think they gotta be 16 inches. Do I not have a freaking ruler in this bag? It's in there somewhere. Ah. We'll put them in here. We'll measure them when we get back to the truck. I think they gotta be. You know what? I'm gonna put them in the cooler real quick, run to the truck, get a tape measure, and measure them. All right, fam, this dude is 14 and a half inches, almost 15 inches. Woo! Can y'all see that? So we're gonna go ahead and toss him back, just for safety's sake. I don't wanna be out here fishing, having fun, then a game warden catches with that thing and then tell us we owe a $500 fine. So it ain't worth it for a couple of pieces of meat. So we're gonna go ahead and toss him back, fam. Woo! But boy, was that fun. Good googly moogly. Yeah, baby. What a day, what a day. Tell the fam bye, y'all. Tell them bye.
Bye, y'all.
Booyah. Uh-oh, an easy release. Lady Red, check it out, easy release. Boom, bam, let's get back out here. Whoo, whoo, was that fun. What a day. The old gangster, Roselle. Whoo, would've kept that. Yes, sir. Roselle of yesteryear, 40-year-old Roselle, 45-year-old Roselle, 50-year-old Roselle, yeah, 59-year-old Roselle. Yes, but I am a mature 61, and I know better. I know how to follow the rules. And like I said, I'm going to get $3 worth of fish off that thing. And if the game warden show up, and I don't know what the fine is, $250, $300, and it ain't worth it. Like I said, it was 2 inches short. I've dealt with that before. We all good. Ain't worth it. Swimming sideways. Alrighty then. Another lipless fish. These boys are starting to thaw out now, y'all. Alright, fam. Okay, what time is it? I don't know. Fam, it is 9:47. Let's get this to 10:30, and then we're going to go and start cleaning our fish and maybe cook us a little breakfast or slash lunch, brunch. Kind of chill for a while. Wait for Lady Red to get up around 2:30. She's working right now. And see what the rest of the day brings us. Then we're going to go straight home and edit this video so y'all can see what kind of day I had. It's a beautiful thing. Got him, fam. Booyah! Perfect hook set. Check him out, fam. What is that? Victim number 5, I believe it is. Let's get a couple of more, and we're going to call it a morning. No, you're fine. Wow, fam. You said that's his first time. That boat's first time in the water. That is nice. Yes, sir. That's how you do it. You only live once, fam. Fam, speaking of only live once, all the time in the comments, I get people telling me how motivational it is for them to see me out here doing what I do on the cheap. I don't own a big expensive boat. My gear is pretty relatively inexpensive, and I just make it happen. Life's too short for us to be waiting for tomorrow. I got a good friend of mine. He retired about a year before I did, which would be about 3 years ago. He was at my house about a month and a half ago, 2 months ago. I got a text message 2 weeks later saying that he was in the hospital. He went in the hospital 1 week, and the next week we were putting him in the ground. He enjoyed 3 years of retirement. Fam, life's too freaking short for us to be sitting here waiting on tomorrow. If you can make it happen today, make it happen. And there's nothing stopping us. Even if our finances ain't the best, you still can take. I bought a bag of shrimp for $3 freaking. I forgot to go get worms. I took what I had, and I have had a spectacular day. Let this be an example to you, fam. Life is what is as complicated as we make it. No matter if we have an illness, if our finances aren't right, no matter what, take a moment for yourself to reflect and enjoy. That's all I'm saying. Me and Lady Red ain't rich. We saved. We saved as much as we could. What does that old saying say? Make what you can as much as you can make. Can it. Put it away. And we did that. And so now we can live a good life. Lady Red's still working in order to keep our insurance going. And we're living a great life. Bam. All right, let's see if we... That's enough about that. Let's see if we go ahead and get these fish. When you have an interruption like that with that boat, it takes those fish about 2-3 minutes to come right back where they were. That's their home. So let's see if we pick one up. All right, fam, we cast over right over yonder. Y'all can see that. And hopefully it drifts back toward me and we pick up a fish on the way. Bam. Turtle. Probably a turtle. Yep. Yes, as I suspected. Now, what are we going to do here? Oh. Break me off. Piece of that Kit Kat bar. You want to break off of him? I knew it. Not gonna let me get the hook out. See ya. Fam, fantastic day of fishing. That's how I like to do it, baby. It ain't about catching monsters, which we caught some pretty good ones today. It ain't about quantity, it's about quality of time. I had a great time. My therapy session was a total success. Woo! I actually had a net with me today, and for that garfish, we actually needed it. If I knew how to make garfish balls and all that, I would have definitely kept that dude. I'm trying to figure out which way to put this net. I think I had it in facing with the net facing forward and the handle. Nope. I would try to set it up and pretend I'll be sleeping in here. And if I do, what's the best way to have all my equipment? And I think the best way is to have that net at my feet. I wouldn't want that in my face. Booyah! All right, fam. We're all tied back on. I'm gonna put our pole up overhead. Let me get up on this. Ooh, boy. Your boy gotta go take a shower. Wow. Yeah. I offended myself. Good googly moogly. Man, when you offend yourself. All right, we're just gonna lay this one across the bed. That's that 6.5 footer. A little bit too long to go up top. But I did order from Temu some of those pole wraps with the Velcro on. So when you break them down, you can wrap it and they'll stay stationary. All right, fam. We're gonna go further up in the park. We're gonna clean these fish, but I don't think we're gonna do a catch, clean, and cook today. So we're gonna leave this one right here. All right, fam, y'all hold on. All right, fam, like I said, I think we're gonna go ahead and leave this one right here. We're not gonna do a catch, clean, and cook, cause your boy's tired. So we're gonna clean these fish up real quick. And we're gonna take it to the house. Now what I will do, what I might do, I wanna try to stuff that flounder. So I'll go ahead and dehead that flounder, scale it, get it cleaned up. And if I cook that flounder, whether I oven bake it or put it in the air fryer or whatever, I think I might bring y'all in for that. So fam, with all that being said, This is probably going to be about a 25-30 minute video, but I had a fantastic time. So we're going to go ahead and bring her in for a landing, fam. And if y'all enjoyed this video, y'all give your boy a thumbs up. Oh, before we close out, just remember this. The main topic of this video, and that's not how it started out, I did not have everything I needed, but I did not give up. I was planning on leaving, going to get some worms. I may have not come back. I may have went to another location, but staying there, perseverance, staying there and toughing it out, just using what I had, the shrimp. Oh, I could have used artificial. I caught some fish. I got my third possession in, and I'm good, fam. So stick with it, fam. It doesn't take a whole lot to go out there and catch some fish, enjoy this beautiful freaking weather and what the days that we have. Because like I said, tomorrow ain't promised, fam. So now that I got that out of the way, once again, if y'all enjoy what we're doing here, this and that, if you're enjoying this video, give us a thumbs up. And if you're enjoying what we do here, this and that, consider becoming a subscriber. And if you do subscribe, hit the notification bell so you'll be notified every time we drop one of these awesome videos. It's your boy, Rosie. Peace.